Real quick thing, guys. Actually, two quick things. So, one, I just got a new P.O. box. It's going to be down in the description. Davenport, Iowa, 2633. I know a couple guys have been asking, but I got a new P.O. box if you guys ever, for some reason, wanted to send me something. If you guys do ever send me something, you will for sure be getting a handwritten thank you note for me back. I just had a couple people asking, so that's out there. And second thing is, be sure to subscribe, please. Thanks. Well, guys, good morning, good afternoon, and good evening to all. Welcome to Hartung Family Farms. And today, it's Sunday, November 10th, and I'm up here before the guys are back from church. I think I had a KC breakfast or something, fundraiser breakfast. So I'm gonna go out and move corn stock piles before they get here. Looks like they had a good day of harvesting soybeans yesterday. So hopefully we can have another good day today. So guys, I can't find a bale mover right now. So what I'm doing is I'm just stacking them in rows of eight. That way we can just drive the bale mover right in between those two stacks and load them up. A lot of guys are running right now. I saw about three combines doing corn on the way up, and a couple of them getting ready to start up for beans. Oh, probably noon or so. Frost has died off, so we can get moving. Anyway, all I'm doing is just kind of going in here, picking up these bales, stabbing in, lifting up, curling back, and going to get the next loader. Is it's got bale forks in the front and back, so I can control the height of this up and back one. And I just basically I go grab two and then start a stack. So just stab in them, don't want it to drag, then lift up. And that's all I'm doing, is just making stacks like this. Simple enough, but it'll save us a lot of time when we want to start moving these bales. Alrighty, I got four stacks done. Time for me to go eat some lunch. My grandma just called. Need to get some go-go juice now. About a little under a quarter. Never hurts to get some go-go juice. Time to go grab some food. Little buggers are cold, aren't ya? Yeah, you're all hunkered in by the house. Nothing beats homemade bread, homemade apple crisp, steak, potatoes, corn. Oh my gosh, I am in heaven. So let's go out. I think I'm gonna go unload the grain cart that's full of soybeans right now and then start combining beans. Sweet, so Nathan's got the 400 warming up right now. It should be good to go. We got our neighbor Kevin Huffman coming down, and Pat, they're going to be running combines. Nathan and myself are probably going to be running carts. And then we got Nathan's buddy Mark that's going to be probably watching the auger. So we're just going to be probably trucking stuff. That way we're just going to leave the auger set up and just run grain carts back to the field. So let's go ahead and get the 400 and start unloading this full load on here. Getting the old hoss backed out. The Brent 1082. Been a great grain cart for us. We absolutely love it. Some guys are commenting how the one tire always looks smaller. Well, a lot they're the same size of tire, but when you're on a hill, a lot of your weight goes on the one side, so it makes the tire really squat. That's just kind of why it looks goofy. Getting the auger up right now, trying not to hit anything. You guys can kind of see we got an unpreferred zone builder right there. I'm hoping we get to use it this week, before we get froze out. I'd like to put it on the 340 and do this bean ground here. That'd be phenomenal. You guys can kind of tell we like our unpreferred products. Unpreferred zone builder, unpreferred Brent grain cart, unpreferred Brent gravity wagon. Pretty sweet. Just unloading right now. The wee one wanted to be on the camera. This is my goddaughter Amber, right? What's your last name?
Hartung.
Who's your dad?
Pat.
So Pat's her dad. So she's hanging out with me. We just got done unloading the grain cart loads, and now we're gonna finish putting it in the bin and then get ready to combine some beans, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Just topped out the semi, and Nathan is feeding cattle right now. We're gonna go park this thing and then see what we need to do. Alrighty, Calvary's heading out. The two grain carts are heading over there. The combines are already across the road. Let's head there.
Okay.
There's Nathan's friend getting a crash course.
Nobody can see him. It's too small.
So Pat's starting up right now. Nathan's gonna hop in the other combine for now. And we're gonna get rolling. It's about 12:30. About time to get these two 30-foot heads moving. First dump of the day. Now that's how you haul bales, guys. Good Lord, that guy is gutsy. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 bales on that little John Deere 7400-ish.
13.
Dang.
13.
That's a lot. So Pat's already making his way back here. And we're moving.
Let's go. Do we have to go underneath him?
Yep. We're gonna go underneath them, unload them to go. Dust is flying now. Nathan, the good old 2588, 30-foot neighbor's 30-foot header, getting some stuff done. Loading them to go with Nathan right now. Gotta get pretty close. This is a pretty short on load auger. There's like a 24, 25 foot. It's very nice having this 30-foot header.
Hey guys, we are combining beans today again, up in the cab. I'm running the 2588 with a 30-foot head, and my dad is in the other combine, which he is going to be going by, as you can see. Kind of a cool shot. We got this field opened up last night, and we're getting it opened up. We just cut through the middle, so things get going pretty fast now. This is a 100-acre field, so let's see how fast we can knock it out. Yielding pretty good. I don't know if you guys can see that or not. Doing about 60. Moisture's about 12. I would hope it'd be dry by now, as it is middle of December, or November, I'm sorry.
Alrighty guys, so I'm kicking Amber out. She's gonna go ride with her dad for a little bit. We just got word, about 60 bushel an acre right now, average so far, 12% moisture, so pretty dang good. So we're gonna go hop out. Amber's gonna go hop in with Pat, and I need one more dump to fill me up. There's Curtis at 7120. Took Eve and his buddy are gonna go haul manure. Back dumping right now, back here. So when Kevin Huffman gets here, he'll take Nathan's spot in the combine. Nathan will come over here and watch the wagon. Well, it'll be much more efficient. We might start lagging behind here, because I got to dump and then basically wait for the wagon to empty before I can leave. Sweet. So now I'm just going to wait for the wagon to go down and empty, and then dump, finish the cart, wait for the wagon to empty, head back over there and get another load. These handhelds by Midland, and overall these Midland radios, we love them so far. I'm over a mile and a half away from them. And last year we would have not have been able to communicate with him, but I have this handheld with me. Mark, the new grain cart driver, doesn't know how to unload yet, so I was talking back how we want to work this out logistically. And without these radios from Midland, I don't know what we do. So far, my stamp of approval, these things are awesome. I'm gonna go switch with Nathan's buddy who's helping us out on grain cart today. He doesn't know how to unload this, so I'm gonna go switch with him. I'm gonna go take this and unload, and he's gonna hop in the Steiger. Alrighty, now I'm in Old Blue. I switched out with Mark. He's gonna get Nathan here soon. So I'm gonna take this back and just get her dumped. It's been a while since I've driven this one. In this video, I'll go through a little bit of the differences between our two grain cart tractors, but biggest difference being, it's a smaller frame tractor pulling it. It's got similar horsepower. It's got like 60 less, I'd say. But it's smaller, it sits shorter. I like running the other one with grain cart. Alrighty, I'm about to unload this one now. You guys want, I can do a how to drive our grain cart video like I did last year if you guys are curious. A lot of you guys wonder why we keep old equipment around. Well, this is exactly why. Because we don't need to have a $50,000 tractor to run this PTO. We have a tractor that's been paid off for over 50 years. And it just runs. Nothing wrong with a good old 706. This is a little bit dirty. We think I told Nathan, we think we found a problem with one of the combines. We overloaded the fan on one side, so yeah, this is a lot dirtier than we would have liked. So we're gonna get that cleaned up. Nathan already cleaned it up, is what I heard. Because what we don't want is all this trash in here. All this trash and pods. Obviously, you don't consume this. So you wanna get it as clean as possible so you don't get docked at the elevator. On the bright side, when it's cold and I forgot my coat in the other tractor, the 706 and nice gas engine really warms me up. This is also why we keep gravity wagons around, so we can just come up and dump from a grain cart. Don't have to worry about it. It's really quick and clean. That's why we like to keep at least one or two. We only have one right now. We're actually looking for a 744 or 747 Brent wagon. If you guys know where any are, or if you guys are selling any 757, I think, not 747. Up done. Whee! Love air ride seats. Doing work, guys. I don't know, ballpark, we've gotten 40 acres done or so. Not quite 35, but done quite a bit so far. Basically, there's probably like 10 acres left going that way, and then another probably 50. You gotta kind of see corn there, and there's probably the 50 acres on the other side of that corn in the bottom ground. Bottom ground was planted about 3 weeks later than this stuff up top, mainly because we had a really wet patch of spring up until early June. So this stuff, the stuff up top was planted late May. The stuff on the bottom there was planted mid-June, 3 weeks later. And here comes Mark, he's ready to swap me out. I can take this red one back to the barn, back to the gravity wagon and start unloading again. The big difference between our 1082 grain cart, which is like 5 or 6 years newer than our 882, is the spout. The spout is actually angled like this, more like a 135 degree, whereas the other one's just a straight line. And it makes a heck of a difference. It's just much more straight down, where the other one kind of shoots it out more. Yeah, it's about full. I hope they get this tank situation figured out, because the tank sample is very, very dirty. And another one bites dust.
Yeah.
Another one bites dust. I'm on my way back. For those of you guys, I don't know if I told you guys yet, but no, we did not chop all of those soybeans. We chopped about half of them. Getting stuff done. Another load down, guys, but while I was actually unloading that load, I took the drone up in the air. Let's take a look at those shots. Hope you enjoy my voiceover. And if you guys do want me to switch back to music, let me know. Card up here. Voiceover or music? What do you think? Alrighty, but for this video, we are going to be doing a voiceover, and I promise you I am trying not to yawn, but I'm already starting to yawn. So, anyway, guys, we are in the middle of soybean harvest. So if you guys don't know, we are over next door. Right there is our big grain leg with our big tower dryer, which you guys can see in the background. Right here, we are using the 644 gravity wagon, dumping into the Merritt or the Westfield auger, which is powered by the 706. I love this shot. That was just kind of really, really cool, seeing that pillow block bearing and the grain falling out. But anyway, so I was kind of on auger duty the entire day. It was actually was kind of fun. You know, it was really loud. My ears were ringing the last couple days. I really needed to bring earplugs. Got to take lessons from Cola Cornstar on that one. But it was just kind of cool. It gave me the opportunity to relax, just, you know, keep caught up on Instagram, do a live video during that feed, fly the drone, which you guys can kind of see right here is our big field with that little dry patch right there. Sorry about that. But anyway, that was a dry patch that they combined around that we actually ended up planting around. But here's over at McDonald's piece. This is about 100-acre field right here. You can kind of see the big ridge going down there. It's actually steeper than what you think. It's actually pretty dang steep. But we have both combines running in this field. We have the 2588 and the 30-foot header that we're borrowing from our neighbor who's actually running this combine right now. And then the Steiger 400 tractor. So we're borrowing his 30-foot header mainly because we had a lot to do and a little time to get it done. Before 5 days ago, gosh darn, I told you guys I promised I wouldn't yawn or at least try to yawn. But before 4 days ago, 5 days ago, before this video, we had 50 acres of soybeans done and 600 acres left, which was a lot, especially because we knew there was snow coming. So what we ended up doing is we asked him if we could, hey, can we rent this head from you? And he was like, sure. So when we do not have this head, what we actually have to do is we have a 20-foot header, which you guys kind of saw a link up in the cards up in the top right-hand corner right now. But we had a 20-foot auger header, which we use. And you guys may wonder why we have such a small head. Why do we use it? Well, there's one big, big reason why we use it, and that's because it's been paid off for years. A lot of people don't underestimate, and I touched on this before, a lot of people underestimate the value of using equipment that's paid off. It's really nice. It's one less thing you have to pay for while you're trying to make payments and make ends meet on already tight margins in the farm. So that's why we're on that 20-foot header, but this is a 30-foot brand new auger header. It's a 2017, but this is the first year it's been used. It's not my favorite purchase that we've ever made, but it works. It works. I mean, it choose away crop. We can go 3 and a half mile an hour with this thing, and that's really all we need. I mean, we're putting away beans. It's 60, 65 bushel beans in this stuff, and it's honestly not too bad at all. We like it. It's cheap. It was really cheap to trade this in. Kudos took care of us. We ended up pulling the trigger on this. I loved the shot that I did. How Mark was telling me, hey, get that drone out of here. So I did a drive-by on him or a fly-by on him. But anyway, so back to the 2588. So this is, like I said, our neighbor running this. It's his bean head that he let us use for about 2 weeks, and it really made a difference. As Evan was touching on before, in 3.5 harvest days, we ended up doing about 400 acres of soybeans, which is awesome. without that extra 10 feet of header on there, we wouldn't have been able to get that done. But I mean, a 2588 is like a class and a half, a high. Sorry, the 7088, but it still handles the 30-foot auger header. The seven, you can kind of see as I do a big panorama of the landscape. Right there, those bean fields on the left are ours. The cornfield is not. The two cornfields right there are not. But the soybean field is ours. But as you guys can kind of tell, the 7088 has a lot left in it compared to the 2588. The 2588 is a good match for this 30-foot auger header, but the 7088 could definitely take a 35-foot auger header, maybe even a 35-foot draper. I'd like to get a seal, a 35-foot draper put on that. I was really hoping there was an auction earlier this summer that I actually had a video on, if you guys are curious. I walked around it, but there was a 35-foot auger header that had integrated transport that I really, really wanted us to get. But anyway, we didn't do it. We went with the cheap option, but which is, like I said, it's not bad. These days with tight margins, you got to do what's best for our farm. And for right now, that 30-foot auger header that was brand new was best for our farm. We knew it would work, and it's been a good head so far. They're reliable, they're lightweight, and they work. So we're just about finished up. There's about 18 acres left in this field. I believe this grain cart and one more finished it. So with the bottom right now, and I just hear on the radio that they're talking about coyotes, and I was like, ooh, coyotes, let's get the drone in the air. I'm kind of curious. But anyway, I caught this kind of cool, these next couple shots, which are pretty cool. I always like, my favorite type of shot, I told Alex from the lower, oh, here's the coyotes. Anyway, so I heard them on the coyotes, and Pat said, ooh, in front of me. So I was like, ooh, let's go look. I've never really seen a coyote up close, so I figured, it was just kind of weird. They're all three right around there, so I figured I'd fly up there just kind of see what's really what they're looking at. So I kind of chase him for a little bit. Probably shouldn't do that, but it's all right. But anyway, as I was mentioning before, I told Alex Miller Roush Farms that this type of shot right here is my favorite. Just kind of even with the ground, kind of just going slightly faster than him. It was just a really cool day. The only thing that could have made this drone shots and this day better is if it wouldn't have snowed 5 inches at the end of the day, and if the sun would have been out, because it was right at golden hour, which would have been really, really nice. But anyway, guys, this is the last video as of right now, October 12th. I do not have any more footage filmed. We've been snowed out for 5 inches. I'm hoping when this video comes out that I will actually be out in the field filming some more stuff. But lots of cool stuff coming, guys. We are not even 10% done with corn harvest yet. So stay tuned and be sure to subscribe if you haven't already. Thanks, guys. Let's go back to the regular video.
Less than 20 acres left. We're moving. Mark just waved at you. Kevin's up top, Pat's down the bottoms.
Alrighty, guys, I'm gonna switch GoPro mounts. I'm gonna put the phone on. Let's do a live stream. See if I can make that work. Alrighty, guys, just had a very good live stream. Be sure to check that out if you haven't. But on my last load, I'm probably gonna dump in. I'm probably gonna fill the bin with this load here. So I gotta be careful and climb up and down the bin a couple times. So I gotta be safe about it. So 706 is still choo-choo. The 8050 is still choo-choo. 644 is looking styling. Profiling. Realiling. Yeah. So it's kind of hard to see, but we have a bearing going out on this thing. You can kind of tell how it's not in the center of that block. Change kind of angle. Yeah, this bearing's already out. I'm just trying to limp it by because we'll have needed about 100 bushel up in that bin until it's full. So I'm trying to limp it by.
All right, I didn't bring my camera up there for safety reasons, but I got that bin full, topped off, shut up, so it is ready for the snow. So I'm gonna pull ahead, dump my auger, turn on my spout right now so I let all the beans out. I'm gonna pull ahead, fold down my spout, and we are all done over here. Mark's gonna go park the grain cart and give Kevin a ride over to his truck, and I'm gonna go fill up my dad full of feed for the cattle. If you guys remember from last year, we like to give our cattle feed that they can munch on when it gets really cold, and it's supposed to get really cold early next week, so that's fun. So I'm with the loader tractor right now. I gotta go get my dad some feed so we can bring down to Bellevue. So I gotta use the loader tractor because we don't have the bale forks for the skid loader right now. So I'm gonna dump this thing here. Hopefully I can set it down. Now I'll pull out, set this bale in front somewhere. Alrighty, so I got the old crappy bale dumped off my dad's bale wagon. I'm heading back. We baled some hay last week. So I'm gonna go back and grab two good hay bales. I'm gonna bring them to my dad so he can take them up to Bellevue.
and then get him going up to Bellevue because it's already late. Woo! Speed racer. Here comes Pat with the 30-foot auger head, brand new. Well, not brand new anymore, but I'm gonna go back and get skid loader so I can fill up my dad with feed, and we'll put two of those bales on. Well, my dad already took off before I could get a video of what all I was doing, but basically I just two scoops of earlage, which you'll see us chopping full bore here hopefully early this week, and then two round bales that we got for the cattle, because we like to do that for the cattle when it gets really cold out, and it's gonna get down to below zero here shortly in the next 2 days. So that's why we did that. But right now I'm going to go pull the header cart down for Pat. We got 11-12 more acres of beans to do, and then beans are done down in Preston. So we're gonna do that before the snow flies. There goes Pat, he's gonna head down there. I'm gonna go hook onto the header wagon real quick and then pull that down. So we're just going over to our little cemetery piece. It's about an acre. It's honestly, it's our smallest piece that we got, and this is gonna be fun. Alrighty, ladies, gents, and germs, grub a dub dub time from my grandma. Oh, I'm excited. It's probably gonna be two burgers, which, yes, it is, two burgers. I appreciate that. Thanks, Grandma. There's Pat right now just chooching out this field. It'll take him probably another 2 minutes to finish it. It's only an acre, so I better get hooked up. Last little bit, this little patch. You can kind of see the cutter bar flexing right there. That's how it picks the beans. Alrighty, here goes Pat. He's gonna blow by me. We got one more field left, hopefully before the snow hits. Got about another hour until the snow hits, what we're thinking. We're moving right now. Un mas field. It's fields like this where I absolutely hate what we gotta do, but in order to actually get hooked up on this field, I actually have to pull in here and run over some beans. I mean, it stinks, but we gotta do what we gotta do because there's no way for me to get all the way down on that side of the road and get turned around without going 20 minutes out of my way. So I gotta pull in, we both gotta pull into this field and just run over a little bit of beans. It is what it is. Oh, this just kills me. Oh, I hate it. I hate it a lot. But that's what we gotta do. Here he goes. There we go. There's my ride. Now I'll pull this thing out of the way so it's out of the way, and then Rana's gonna give me a ride back to the grain cart. Just got back in the big grain cart. Now I gotta go down and catch Pat because I bet he's gonna be full by the time I get down there. And it's gonna start snowing anytime here, and I don't wanna go through that little mud hole, so I gotta go kinda out and around and turn around. Sweet. Well, I rode with him for approximately 30 seconds. And then the guy who, Devin Stahl, the guy who runs and gets us feed quite a bit, he's back and needs a ride somewhere, so I'm gonna go get him. It has started snow! I don't want it. Welp, I just lost my mic for a little bit, so the audio is gonna be crap. So I'm gonna be doing a voiceover and trying to kind of basically mimic what I was saying in these next little parts. But we're gonna only got a couple acres left of these beans. We're gonna definitely try and finish it up before the night ends and the snow really starts coming down. And probably call it a harvest at least for a couple days, if not a week, especially if we end up getting 4 to 6 inches like they're now, or 5 to 7 inches like they're now saying. Joy.
Shooting along now, don't have a ton left. Maybe in the next 20 minutes we'll finish up, hopefully. Time to dump on the go. Oh, that stuff is yielding 5 bushel an acre with that corn in there. I'll explain later. And I started this too early, and we're not done yet.
Oh yeah, the reason my pad is literally running over those beans there is because those beans right there were planted a month late, and they got froze out when they weren't even potted out. They were yielding like 5 bushels an acre, and I had a bunch of weeds in them, and they were wet, and it was just miserable. Done. Right as the snow is really starting to come down, and I can just see it starting to stick. So I'm gonna come out and tarp this tarp. We're gonna take these buggers back, start putting everything up, that way it doesn't get full of snow.
I love snow. You love snow. I really, All right, combine. Hitters and hooks from the combine. Grain cart is tarp. Combine hopper is closed. Now we need a bugger home before everything gets all sloppy and messy. Nobody likes that. Harvest 19. Woo!
Driving in a winter wonderland. It almost feels like I'm going into light speed.
Pew! All right. Last thing. Loading up the colt, taking the grain cart home. All right.
Already, guys, gonna call her quits for the night. So there were only 2 clips where I had to do the voiceover, so for the most part it wasn't terrible, so I just left it in that way you guys get the external noises. But anyway, hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you guys did, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. I did get the new mic that's what I'm recording right now, so the next video that I record, it's gonna happen. Follow us on Facebook and Instagram at Hartung Family Farms, and of course, guys, as always, ta-ta.